And my uncle called me and told me, can you just rush to Shell Nakawa and get him? He's been in an accident. So I asked what happened. And he said, he was trying to cross the road. They say he's trying to cross the road and a boat hit him. So I was a bit far, so we tried to start the journey, but it was raining heavily and the traffic was bad. So just within maybe 10 minutes, I called back the number, I called my dad's number, and the man picked up and he was screaming and he was saying, we need a car, we need a car, we need a car that to get him to the hospital really quickly. We're seeing him passing. So I said, I'm far, I'm just living in Jinja, you need to find a quicker way of transport to get him to Nambur. So I called back 5 minutes later and he said he's passed away, he's dead. So I said, he's dead, you've confirmed he's not breathing? He said, yeah, he's dead. Mm. And I said, okay.
So did you have interaction with him in the past few days?
Yeah, I see him every day. He's a very God-fearing person, so every time we live in the house, it's a ritual, he has to pray for you and he has to say God bless you. So that day, yesterday, he actually left me here. He came to my door and he knocked. And he said, he told me what he's going to do for that day. He told me he's going to Kisementi, then he's going to Jumbo Plaza. He's with my uncle the whole day. And then we were supposed to meet at 3 p.m. So he said, God bless you, Laura. I said, God bless you too. So he left. So I called him at 3 p.m. and he said, no change of plan. My meetings are still going on, so we're not meeting. So I said, okay. Then at 4 p.m. they called me and told me he had died.
Did he ever told you that maybe some people would have been following him because of his past?
Yeah, everyone keeps asking that, especially because he had just revived Uganda Confidential. This was just a second issue coming out, and he's always been very controversial. But I think this time it just is what it is. It was an accident. He was just knocked. His head, he must have been preoccupied and like really lost in thought, because that area is a really busy area. The Shell Nakawa, you know, near the market, it's a really busy area. So as much as everyone wants a story, I really think he was just knocked down accidentally. Yeah.
Talk about, you saying that he was about to release another version of the Confidential.
Yeah.
Yes.
When he was still in prison, he had decided that's what he wanted to do. He didn't want to come out and continue down the political route because of obviously the problems he had gotten into. He just wanted to be a journalist, economic strictly, nothing to do with politics. So he had first written 2 issues which didn't do well because no one even recognized it was his writing. Then he got a lot of advice from fellow journalists, Wafula Gutu, Justin. They told him, just go back to the initial concept, the way Uganda Confidential used to look back in the day. People need to recognize it's your brand. So we had just done 1 issue in Feb, and that issue had done really well. All the copies had sold off the shelves. We had started getting advertisers to come on board. The March issue, actually the meetings that they had yesterday were to distribute the second issue. He had just gone to the printer, he had picked up the copies. My uncle is a distributor, they were distributing them yesterday. So things were finally looking up.
So what can you tell us about the content of some of what he has written, the hitting headline in there?
He wanted, his motive was to just improve the economy. He wanted to reduce the interest rate of borrowing. It was all very financial. So you can buy a copy. They're all there on the shelves, buy a copy and see. He was talking about the future of the country. It was things I'm not that keen about. But it was pretty much the same what he had always been taking. To do with economics.
Okay. Just a second.